Tracy Eltoff and Dan Ramsey got married in Duluth, Minnesota in 1993. My mom took under her wing my three half-sisters, Rihanna, Hallie, and Jade. She gave birth to her first son, Joseph, in 1994, and her second son, Polly, was born in 1997. These are my brothers. On August 21st, 1998, in Salt Lake City, Utah, Tracy gave birth to a 7.1-pound baby girl named Danielle Tracy Ramsey. That was me. I had a full head of dark hair and was a little bit chubby. My brothers welcomed me home and helped my mom take care of me. When I was 7 months old, we moved from Utah to Oklahoma City. I don't remember much, but we had a lot of fun there because our house had the best bathroom. I also got my glasses while living there when I was only 18 months old. In November of 2000, we moved to Madison. I was two. Two of my 41 cousins lived here and were closest in age to me and my brothers, so it seemed like a good idea. We moved into a new subdivision surrounded by dirt piles and half-built houses that became our playgrounds. Nothing could keep me and my brothers from exploring this new territory. We collected rocks, found new hideouts, and went on many other adventures. As the neighborhood grew, more kids moved in, and that's how we met our first friends outside the family. I was always trying to learn new things, from basketball to performing in school productions. Like most typical girls, I was into dressing up princesses in anything pink. Dressing up was also a huge passion of mine. I had every outfit imaginable. I could be a fashionista, a baseball player, princess, Teletubby thug, and my favorite was to try and dress up as my mom. I would wait for her to get dressed every day and find an outfit that looked similar. I couldn't just dress up though. I also had to do my makeup. Now letting a little girl who wants to put on makeup be alone with Marcus isn't the best idea. Leaving me alone with my dog, Scruffy, probably wasn't the best idea either. He also became quite the fashionista. Scruffy became my best friend quickly. He was truly the best thing that ever happened to me, but all good things come to an end, and he died at the young age of 5, and I still miss him. You could never replace Scruffy, but we got another great dog a year after he passed. His name is Willie, and we've had him for almost 3 years now, and I couldn't ask for a better dog. When I was 6, my parents got a divorce and my dad moved out. My dad and I weren't that close, so it didn't make that big of an impact on me. More time to be with my mom, so life seemed pretty good. I loved spending time with my mom. She is who I look up to and strive to be when I get older. When she met her boyfriend, Ray, it was hard for me to share her. I eventually grew used to it, and now I have a great guy in my life watching out for me and my family. With him came a new addition to the family, his son, little Ray, and his wife, Vicky. As I got older and into my teenage years, I started to change and realize who my good friends were and what my true passions are. I have many good friends that I'm grateful for, and I love them all. They help me through a lot. Sometimes we fight, but we always pull through it, and I'm so happy to have them in my life. These people are helping me discover who I am and who I want to be. I'm not exactly sure what I want to be when I grow up, but I know it involves art. I love to paint, draw, special effects, anything that has to do with it. I also found out I like to travel over the past year. I spent 2 weeks in Hawaii with my mom snorkeling, tubing, rafting, and many other activities. As a family, we went to New York for my cousin's wedding, which was also really amazing. Another thing I love to do is play volleyball. I tried out freshman year, and I fell in love with my teams and the sport. I am from my mom and dad. The sweet treats and naps. My half-brothers and half-sisters. The swing sets and McDonald's trips. I'm from the new house on the street, going to a new school, meeting my first real friends, experiencing my first crush. I am from the teenage years, the useless drama, friends coming and going, trying to find out who you are. I am from this moment.